What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to Luna Figs. About to head inside Walmart for a toy hunt. Prepare for launch.
We are kicking things off over in Diecast today. Got a few Hot Wheels here. Not really seeing anything new. It's pretty decently stocked. That's pretty cool. Like the finish on that one. It's not the fancy, is it? Nah. I am learning. If you see something with a fancy finish, check. It might be a treasure hunt or a super rare or, you know, something like that. But alas, no luck there. Got some color shifters over here. A little bit of Racerverse. A whole lot of Mario Kart. There's the Shy Guy. Several Porsches still hanging out. A little bit of Matchbox. There's a little Matchbox Mini. And some collectors. And not a ton of monster trucks going on. Some cars, skateboards, a couple of N1s. Huh, how'd that happen? It's going the wrong way. There's Snow Speeder, TIE Fighter back there. Slide Street 2. Oh, these are new. I haven't seen these before. Kinda neat. Not really familiar with what those are. They got them crammed on this peg. So I'm gonna take a few off. There we go. 1, 5, 2, there's 3, there's 4. See any chases or anything. Some dress trucks. I got a Turtle Wax, Coca-Cola, Fanta. Got some M2s and pink slips down here. I don't think I've seen that one before. Anything in the big stuff? Batman and Doctor Strange, some Fast and Furious. I do believe that is going to do it for Diecast in the action figure aisle, and it's looking kind of desolate down through here. I do have a few Transformers, quite a bit of clearance deals. But yeah, it does look like there you are, possibly getting ready for a reset, because there's a lot of empty space right now. Actually saw this at another Walmart for $12, Hallow's Eve. I passed on it because, while it's a cool figure, I have no idea who that is. So I exercised some discipline and passed on it. Got some dinosaurs. Not a lot going on there either. This is just odd. Not much going on at all. Unless you're looking for a Mando. Not even a lot of Vaders here, but tons of Mandos. Got all kinds of Micro Galaxy Asajj Ventress Starfighter. Now we do have some Scout class down here. Looks like it's a brand new box. Yes, who's on this? Got a walker, got a step, arc speeder, and I'm not sure. Oh, that's a Geonosian, looks like. So yeah, then we got some bounty collection over here. Quite a bit of AEW. Doesn't look like it's anything all that new though. There's Hollywood Hulk Hogan Luchasaurus. That's a cool looking figure. Love the tattoos on there. Oh, we got Ravishing Rick Rude Superstar. I don't think I've seen that one. Earthquake. It's been a while since I've seen that one. There's The Rock. And Macho Man Randy Savage. So some newish superstars. At least ones I haven't seen in a while. There's the 3-pack. Got some Ultimates down here. Got the retro carded Joes. Need these to go on clearance so I can pick up my man Duke here. We got a cartoon collection Tila and Stratos. Got a pig head. It's on clearance for $11.50. Some Turtles of Grayskull. And we got Cyclone and Leech. King Keldor, Mechanek. There's Thunder Punch He-Man, awesome figure. There's Revolution Hordak. Oh, there's Revolution Sorceress Tila. And yeah, it's all the Masterverse. Got some Demon Slayer and Dragon Ball, Naruto. Looks like the Demon Slayer's down to $4. Smooth criminal. Oh, there's an Ultimate Hollywood Hulk Hogan. Let's stick him back over here where he goes with his friends. There we go. What else we got over here? Got some Beyblade and Bakugan. Some video game figures. Among Us. Some little Sonic playsets and Mario. Minecraft. Here's a vintage collection Vader. Go stick that back over there with the rest of them. And Pokemon. And we do have some Lego over here down on the end cap. New stuff is starting to hit from Lego. Ah, speaking of which, here is some of the new stuff. There's the helicarrier down there. And here's some of the Target exclusives. And some new sets there. Got the Duel on Peridia from Ahsoka. That's really cool. We have Jedi Bob Starfighter up top here. If you're a Lego Star Wars fan, you know who Jedi Bob is. If you're not, you have no clue who Jedi Bob is. But evidently he was an exclusive set in an old Republic cruiser back in the day, or Republic gunship. It has a bit of a cult following among Lego Star Wars fans. But that's it for this little section of Lego. Let's hit the main one and see what they got over there. Over in the Lego section, we got the Office and the Ornithopter. Some botanicals. Still really nothing new. Do have this awesome display. Quite a bit of Star Wars. But I'm not seeing much of the new Star Wars over here. only seen the Dark Falcon once, and I was not recording at the time, and I have not seen it since. I don't know if it's just not getting put out or just that popular is getting sold. Over to the main Lego aisle. Still got some clearance deals going on. There's the Batwing. Oh, that's a new set. The double-decker sightseeing bus. Disney. Yeah, not much going on there. This is really odd. I mean, we're well over a week into August, and a lot of the new sets just aren't showing up yet. I think Target might have a little bit better selection as far as the new stuff goes. Of course, you can always go to a Lego store if you have one, or Lego.com. They're all on there. Yeah, that is it for Lego, and not much new. Yeah, we got a Ninja Turtles display. Seen this several times, but just in case it's your first time with me, we'll check them out. Got the Mutations, some new Mutant Mayhem. It's pretty cool. I do like the Mechazoid. And there's a Metalhead somewhere. That's pretty cool if I can find one. But I don't see one. So I can't show it to you. Oh, there's a one more Beaten Mayhem set. Bebop and Rocksteady Babies. Well, there's his head. Metalhead's head. But that's it. All right, let's head over to collectibles now. Back in collectibles, we've got this little Netflix section now trending. Yeah, the new Ghostbusters movie is on Netflix now. Still haven't watched it, but I need to check it out. Got some Last Ronin down here. Deadpool and Wolverine was awesome. Let's see, I think we got some more stuff down here. So let's just walk over here and see what they got. Got Crunchyroll anime. There's Chainsaw Man. Spy Family. Up here's the Battle Damage Last Ronin. Naked Turtle. Avert your eyes. There's Dragon Ball Goku Black. Naruto. Some cool anime stuff. And we got the horror section from Bloody Disgusting. There's the black and white Wolfman and Hunchback Ninja Turtles. I think they announced at Comic-Con to come out with more of that line. Still got some of the Ultimate NECA figures. Ghostface. Hannibal Lecter. And still got Toxie up here. It's pretty cool. And Terrifier and House of a Thousand Corpses. So, yeah, some cool horror stuff. Now we're over in the regular collector section. Got the Three Deeps. Looks like they are on clearance here. Got Disruptor. There's Stitch. Already got him. Little Chucky Kids Mill. Oh, there's the Biker Mice from Mars. Let's see, this is Throttle. That's the only one they seem to have out. I've seen, I see the rest of them. We'll get to those in just a second. There's Monkey D. Luffy figure arts. Cool Boba Fett pop. There's Super from Jaws. Some Gundam. There's the Wanderer. We got Mike Myers.
or Michael Myers, not Mike Myers. That's a different guy. Mistress of the Dark, Red Fright and Boo. There's Alf, Batman, some Mego, and then here's the rest of the Biker Mice from Mars. There's Moto and Vinny, and another Throttle there. So they got all three of the Biker Mice if you're after those. And some Pops. Oh, a Scoops Ahoy Robin. Sherbert Surprise. I've not seen this one yet. Wonder if that's scented. That'd be cool. Ninja Turtles, based on the original vintage figures. Those are cool. For some reason, only Leo and Raph are showing up at Walmart's. I did see all four of them at Books A Million a while back. All right, that is going to do it for collectors. Gonna head back to clearance, see what they got back there. Over in clearance, and we do have a few things. Got a Isabelle from Fortnite. Mini Bratz. Little Ninja Turtle skate parks. There's Black Adam. Kai Brightstar. The Pink Ranger down to $9. I'm not even sure that's a clearance price, but they do have some Star Wars concept art. And we've got some Legends down to 15. A little bit of wrestling. Nothing crazy there. Oh, Beetlejuice Clingers, that's kind of neat. And Transformers. There are some more of those 3Ds. It's pretty neat. There's the Nightmare Before Christmas. We'll spin around over here. Got a little remote control Mikey on a skateboard. Some dinosaurs. Mm-hmm. And we got some Black Series over here. Got the holiday security droids still hanging out. Seen the Nutcracker trooper showing up at Ollie's. So I have to keep an eye out for that. I kind of want that one. We do have Andor for 19. Some more wrestlers. There's Street Style Leo. And got some Star Wars Mission Fleet. $17 for the T6. And Spider-Woman Pop for $6. And finally, the Mega Mutant for $18.50. That is going to do it for clearance and the Walmart Toy Hunt. Let's go wrap it up.
And that is it for this Walmart Toy Hunt. Back at the Nerd Den, wrapping things up. Empty-handed. Didn't see anything I needed today. That's not to say you didn't see anything. Did see some new stuff in there. Kick things off over in Diecast. Hot Wheels looking pretty good. Had that new series, Street Sliders. That was pretty cool. Hadn't seen those before. Did head over to the Action Figure Aisle. Not a ton going on there. Looked kind of bare in there, but I did see a lot of clearance deals on Transformers, so that was nice. Star Wars, not much going on other than the little Scout Class Micro Galaxy. Neat seeing those. Masters of the Universe, lots of Masterverse figures. Really cool, that Thunder Punch He-Man. Pretty cool, I already have that one. Thunder Punch He-Man was one of my He-Mans as a kid. So that one holds a special place for me, but that figure is really cool. I think it's probably one of the better He-Man figures we've gotten. So if you're into Motu, Masterverse, check that one out. It's really cool. Did see some of the new Lego sets showing up. Had a Jedi Bob Starfighter. That's pretty cool. Go look him up if you're interested. Little bit of lore there. So if you're into Lego Star Wars, check him out. I think you might be interested. He's going to be in that new series, Rebuilding the Galaxy. So looking forward to seeing that. Still haven't seen the Dark Falcon yet. I've seen it once, but I haven't filmed it for you yet. So I'll keep an eye out for you, see if I run across that. Did see the midi-scale helicarrier from Marvel, so that was pretty neat. The Battle on Peridia, or Duel on Peridia, I think is actual name of the set, from Ahsoka. Really cool minifigs in that set. Might have to pick that one up. Really cool figures. Got Ahsoka, Sabine, Thrawn. So yeah, some really cool figures in that one. Didn't see many other sets other than on that end cap. We did see the tour bus, the double-decker tour bus. So I'm not sure where all the other new sets are, because there's supposed to be a lot of new Lego sets. And we're well over a week into August, and they're still not showing up very much. I think Target probably has a little bit better selection on the new sets. Haven't seen a lot showing up at Walmart just yet. But keep an eye out. Hopefully they'll show up soon. We headed over to the collector section after Lego. Have all the new specialty sections over there. They've been showing up over the last month or two. Good to see all of the Walmarts in my area having all those. Let me know if those are showing up in your area. I think pretty much every Walmart that I go to has those sections now. So I know a lot of people were thinking they were going to be kind of selective and rare, but they're everywhere out here, and they got still quite a good selection. A lot of NECA, the Ninja Turtles, the horror figures. We saw the battle damaged Last Ronin, the Naked Turtle. You know what? It'd be kind of cool to get like four of those and maybe swap off parts from the other Last Ronin figures, do like a head swap or something, and make all four turtles, but you know, more of the stripped down versions. Without all the extra gear. Just an idea. Be kind of expensive at $35 a pop, but no, be kind of cool to do that. We hit the main collector's aisle. Did see the biker mice from Mars. That was really cool. Not into that. That was kind of after my time growing up, so I'm not really familiar with that, but those have been showing up. There's three different figures. I think they had all of them there. As I said, let me know if you were into Biker Mice from Mars. Let me know what the lore is. I don't know anything about that series from back in the day. Did see the Scoops Ahoy pop. Hadn't seen that one before. I wonder if it was scented. I didn't look that close. But definitely a cool color scheme, kind of a pastel look to it. So a new pop on the shelves is always cool. Then we headed back to clearance. Had quite a bit back there. No crazy deals or anything, but was well stocked. So a lot of clearance deals still to be found if you keep an eye out for them. As I mentioned, I did see Hallows Eve at another Walmart. It was down to $12, but I did pass on it because I don't know who Hallows Eve is. I know she's a Spider-Man villain, and I do Spider-Man stuff, but she must be fairly new because I haven't read a Spider-Man comic in a while. And so I just didn't know who she was. Exercised a little bit of discipline and didn't pick that up when I saw it the other day. But oh well. I'm empty-handed, but not to say I didn't see anything today. But let me know if you saw anything you're interested in. The wrestling section looked pretty good. Again, I don't know anything about wrestling, but I'm sure you guys do. So let me know if I missed anything spectacular over in that section. But that is all I have for today. If you are new here, do me a favor, hit that subscribe button, turn on your notifications, and I will see you guys next time around.